Hi, it's Vicky here, and today I'm sharing my latest art journal layout. Today's layout is all about cinema and movies, and that's why I will be using this Tim Holtz stamp set, which is called At the Movies, as well as some bits and pieces that I have grabbed from my stash. So to start off, as you can see, I have used my pencil and I sketched out the front of a vintage camera, a vintage movie camera. So I'm using my scissors to cut it out. It doesn't have to be perfect, as you can see. I just want to have the general idea of having a camera at the edge of my layout. So now I am going to punch out a circle out of the same black pattern paper. And this is going to be my camera. So now I'm using my ruler and I'm going to draw two lines, and these are going to be actually the light that is coming out of the camera. So in order to color it and not create a mess out of it, I am using some masking tape. Now my masking tape was a bit sticky, and that's why I'm using my fingers to remove some of the stickiness. And now I'm sticking it. I don't know if you can actually see the pencil line there, but I am following the pencil line. I am sticking this masking tape at the inside of that pencil line. So I'm going to do that for both the edges, and I am going to use my scissors to cut out the excess. And now that I have my masking tape in place, I can go ahead and start coloring my background. Now for my background, I am going to be using a distress paint by Tim Holtz, and that's why I want to have a nice gessoed surface so that it doesn't absorb too much paint. And that's what I'm doing here. I'm using gesso by Faber-Castell, which is nice and thin. I prefer using gesso, thin gesso, for my background washes because it's so easy for me to apply gesso quickly, and it also dries pretty fast. Once I cover up the whole area, I can then go ahead and use my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and then I can move on with painting my background. I want to keep my background quite dark, and that's why I'm starting out by using Rusty Hints Distress Paint by Tim Holtz. And as you can see, I'm using the dabber to dab some paint over the page, and then with my baby wipe I apply the color. Now notice that my baby wipe isn't very wet. It is actually more dry than wet, and what I am trying to do here is to cover up the whole background with my first color. I'm not trying to have a smooth coverage, as you can see. I will be adding more layers of color at the top, and not having a smooth coverage, it will really add to the final result. One of the best advantages of using a distress paint by Tim Holtz is that it dries permanent, so I can do any technique that I want on top without having the color to smudge or move while I stick things on top or doing my embossing paste, stenciling and everything else. So now I have added some vintage photo to make it even darker. So again I'm using the same technique, applying just a bit of color with the dabber, and then covering up the whole page with my baby wipe. Finally, to add some shimmer and make it even darker, I am using antiqued bronze. This is one of the metallics, and it adds such a nice shimmer on the page. And since I didn't make an effort to have all the layers of colors really smooth, you can see how I have a nice texture at the background now that I'm finished. Finally, to darken up the edges of my layout and somehow frame it, I am using my brown big brush marker and applying some ink while smudging it with my finger. I move fast because I don't want my ink to dry before I get the chance to smudge the ink all around. As you can see, I push the color towards the center of the page, and now that I'm happy with the background, the only finishing touch that I'm going to do is to add some black archival ink at the edges. As you can see, I'm not adding too much, only at the edges, and this is going to finish up the framing of my layout. I'm using archival ink and not distress ink, just because this is not going to smear or smudge as I move on with my background, just because archival ink is permanent. Now that I'm happy with my background, I'm going to tear off the masking tape, and as you can see, I realized that it was more sticky than it should have been. So I managed to tear off a bit at the center of my page, but that doesn't really matter because I am going to cover up again with gesso. And I'm not going to use that masking tape again. Maybe it was so sticky because I used the heat gun over it, and that helped the glue to stick even more than it should have. So this is supposed to be the light that is coming out of the camera, and I am going to cover it up with gesso just because I am going to use distress paint later on to color it. But instead of using this time the masking tape that I had, the painter's tape for masking, I am going to use this Inca Dinka Do paper sheets, which are actually not very sticky, and the stickiness is just like a post-it note. So first of all, I am making sure that I'm not going to make a mess out of this, and then I am going to cover up the whole light with gesso. Before gesso has some time to dry, I am going to tear off the masking tape just to make sure that gesso didn't go under the masking tape. And you will see that I had a great result at the top, but I had some gesso at the bottom, which isn't a problem because this is not dry at all, and I can wipe it off easily with my baby wipe. I'm using my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and now I can go on and color the whole area. I'm using my dabber, and that's the distress paint, that's the color of mustard seed. And as you can see, I'm applying the color directly with the dabber and blending it out with my fingers. When you use your fingers to blend out distress paint, you end up with a very smooth result. To make it more interesting, I am going to introduce some spiced marmalade here and there. I'm not going to add too much, and I'm blending it with my finger. And as I am quite happy with the background at the moment, I am going to work on the camera. I am adding just a bit of tape adhesive at the back of the camera just to secure the circle at the top. And now I am going to decide where this is going to go, and just stick it down with some matte medium. I am going to make sure that I cover up the camera on top with a matte medium, and once this is dry, I am going to use my scissors to cut out whatever sticks out of the page. Now that matte medium is totally dry, I can use my markers to add some shading around the camera. And as usual, I'm using my brown marker to add the shading around the camera. And finally, I'm going to use my black marker to make the camera even darker. The stamp set that I'll be using today is called At The Movies and is designed by Tim Holtz, and I will be using all those stamps today on my layout. So first of all, I'm using this text stamp, and I'm using Archival Ink, that's sepia, to stamp on the brown areas of my layout and create some interesting at the background. Notice how I use the baby wipe at the edges of the stamp to wipe them out of ink. I am doing that because I want to avoid perfect stamping, as well as having big blocks of stamping here and there. And this is the reason why I'm not using a stamping block, and instead I'm using my fingers to touch the stamp on my layout. So now that I'm happy with the background, I'm using my heat gun just to make sure that Archival Ink is nice and dry. I am going to look through my stencils for the stars. And since this is a layout about the movies, I think that stars really complement the whole theme. So I'm using white embossing paste, and I'm going to add some stars only at the top of my layout. To add some shimmer on my camera, I am going to use Brushed Pewter Distress Paint. This is actually silver, and I am just applying a bit with my finger, just to bring it more to life. And now I can move on to create my focal point of the layout today, which is going to be a popcorn box. So to make this box, I looked through my stash and I found this striped pattern paper, which is from a very old pattern paper collection. So I am going to use my Fiskars trimmer to cut it down to size. I was really happy when I found this pattern paper on my stash, because I was looking for a white and red striped pattern paper, but this paper is not only white and red, it's also a specialty paper, so all those red stripes are actually foiled, and it has a nice shimmer on it. Once I have the main shape for my box, I'm going to use again the stamp set by Tim Holtz, and I'm going to stamp the one that says popcorn. I'm using Archival Ink, that's Vermilion, and I'm stamping it on Manila cardstock, and I'm going to use my scissors to cut it out. I am securing my popcorn sign on top of my popcorn box with some tape adhesive at the back, and now I am going to stick everything down on my layout. As usual, I'm using a matte medium as a glue to stick everything down, and I am going to use matte medium to cover up the whole popcorn box. I'm doing so because I am going to use my big brass markers later on to add some shading. And although I have covered up the box with matte medium, I didn't lose the shimmer from the pattern paper. Now at this stamp set there are some popcorns which I am going to cut out with my scissors. I love having details on my layouts, and that's why I really don't mind cutting out all those little pieces. However, I know that you can get the same, pretty much the same results if you have a very small punch of a cloud. And if you punch out many clouds, you can add them one on top of the other, and it will create the illusion of having a popcorn on top of your popcorn box. Now I am using my craft knife to cut out a slit. And then I am going to stack all those little popcorn pieces inside the box. At this point, also note that I have already used my big brass brown marker to add some shading around the popcorn box, as well as on the inside edges of the popcorn box. So now I will continue adding popcorns inside the box until I'm happy with the outcome. And I am going to cover them all up with gel medium at the end, just to make sure that they are nicely secured there. One of my favorite techniques is using a white gel pen and adding highlights on my layouts, and that's what I'm doing here. I'm going all around the camera, And I am also going to add some black outline around the box with my black thin marker. This is by Faber-Castell and it's the small size. And then I am going to add some white highlights around the box as well. As always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using on my blog as well as just below the video if you are watching on YouTube in the description area. I decided to use some white enamel accents on the camera. And I can now go ahead and add the quote on my layout. For today, the quote is "Let's go to the movies." And this is one text by Tim Holtz. This is not supposed to give you a perfect impression, and that's why it's called one text. But you can always go at the end and fill in the gaps that you don't really like with a black marker. And that's what I'm doing here. Also, when I'm stamping my quote, I also make sure to stamp one or two letters at a time, just because it's very bulky and I don't get a nice impression if I stamp the whole word at once. This is a stamp from the same stamp set by Tim Holtz, the one that's called At the Movies, and this is a ticket that says Admit 1, so I have stamped with Archival Ink twice the same image. I am going to use my distress inks to color up those tickets and kind of distress them. So first of all, I'm using T-Dye. And I'm also making sure that the bag is also distressed. And then I am going to ink up the edges with a vintage photo. I am going to secure both tickets at the top of my layout with my mini stapler. Another great embellishment to add to this layout is the movie film that I have, which is by Tim Holtz, and I think it really complements the layout, so I'm cutting out just a piece, and again I am going to staple it at the top along with those two tickets, so I am actually creating a cluster up there. And to add even more texture and interest at the background, I am going to use this stamp, which is again from the At the Movies stamp set by Tim Holtz, and I'm going to stamp it at the edge. So I'm using again sepia, and I'm stamping it along the edge of my second page. The art journal layout is pretty much finished, but I can go on adding little details here and there forever. So that's what I'm doing now. I am adding some highlights on the letters. This is my Signo White gel pen. I love this technique and I keep on doing it in to all my quotes. And I think that it really brings the title to life. And now I am going to add some ribbons. These are ribbons by Tim Holtz and they perfectly match the theme of today's layout. There are tickets, numbers, theater seats, stars that I am going to stick here and there around the layout. And finally, as a finishing touch, I am going to use my gel medium and stick some more popcorns outside the box, as if they have fallen out. And that finishes the art journal layout for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the layout. For more art journal inspiration, you can click any of the three images. Make sure to subscribe on my YouTube channel so you won't miss another video. Thank you all for watching.